Hello friends, today we will learn about while loop and its application. So let's start with an example. Now let's take an example of a lift seen in malls, apartments, etc. In case of lift, it also keeps on checking for a request from the users. Whenever it gets a request from a person, it either moves up or down. This can be represented with a while loop as well. As explained in the previous example, how frequent this lift checks for requests is depends on the design frequency. Before we start coding, we have to assume few things here. Let's say we have 4 floors in a building. Those are 0, 1, 2 and 3. We will maintain a list of requests and the lift will process the request on first come first serve basis. In electronics terms, we do this with the help of shift registers. Once all the request has been processed, the list will return a value 0. So eventually the lift will come to ground floor and settle there. So let's start coding now. Let's assume initially the lift is at ground floor, that is 0. We will write lift position equal to 0. Then when power is on, the lift keeps on checking for the request list. If there are multiple requests, it will start processing the top one, then the second one and so on. Then once it gets a new request, it checks the difference between its current position and requested position. Accordingly, it decides whether to go up or down. If the requested floor number is more than the lift position, the difference is more than 0. It has to go up, that is, lift position will increase by 1 in each round. If the requested floor number is less than the lift position, the difference is less than 0. It has to go down, that is, lift position will decrease by 1 in each round. Once it reaches the requested position, no action is required. But it has to delete the current request from the list so that the next request will come to top and that will be accepted for next round. We are done with this example and this is how the machine will work. You might have seen this for loop example in my last video. In fact, we can do the same thing using while loop as well. Though few things need to be modified. In both for loop and while loop, the condition d less than 6 for existing the loop remains as it is. But there is no place for initial condition d equals to 1 and increment d equals to d plus 1 in while loop. So we will move d equals to 1 just before the starting of while loop and move d equals to d plus 1 to end of the body, where d has to increase by 1 before proceeding for the next day. Now we are done. So if we go through this code, day number d equals to 1 at the start of loop, then it checks for condition d less than 6 is good. So we will enter to while loop. Father gives a candy. Then Twinkle went to school and wrote 1 and drew 1 candy in blackboard and came back to home. Similar thing happens for day 2. Day 3. Day 4. And day 5. Then at the end of the 5th day, d equals to 5 plus 1 equals to 6. Then it will not satisfy the condition and come out from the while loop. Hope you understand the concept of while loop. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel to get the latest videos. Thank you.